Welcome back, MTG Joe here. Today we're going to be trying out some Sultai Dredge in Historic Best of One. This is a deck that I found from Untapped GG. It's got a 68% win rate in Diamond to Mythic rank after 100 games played. So we're going to give this a shot, see if it actually holds up. I just made one change due to personal preference. If you want to use Untapped, the link is in the video description. It's a win rate, like a companion tool that tracks win rates, a whole bunch of stuff. So you can check that out in the description of the video, but we're going to jump in. And then for those of you who are unfamiliar with Dredge, what it is a kind of an ode to an old deck archetype. So modern, you have Dredge cards with an actual ability which can circumvent your draw step, and vintage, stuff like that. But it's kind of the notion when you are a self-mill deck, you are a Dredge deck. And what we're trying to do is take advantage of Prized Amalgam, a new card from Shadows over Innistrad. Basically, if it's in your graveyard and a creature enter the battlefield from your graveyard, you get to return it to the battlefield. So we're self-milling from our deck. We have things like Silversmote, Ghoul that come back from our graveyard if we gain 3 or more life. We can mill over Creeping Chill and gain life that way there. It's free, kind of free cast in a way. We have a bunch of ways to put cards into our graveyard. Stitcher Supplier mills, Founding of the Third Path mills. Nacromeoba is a card that comes back from our graveyard. Seder Wayfinder mills, Glimpse the Unthinkable mills, tens, Grisly Salvage mills. So a lot of ways to mill in the deck. We have Collective Brutality that lets us discard a card from our hand to activate more than one mode. Either opponent discards an instant or sorcery of our choice, -2/2, or -2/+2 for your opponent. The only change I made was I played Woe Strider in place of Driven Despair, like the Aftermath card. I just didn't think that card was doing much. Another way to escape from our graveyard for value. And then a single copy of Haunted Dead. Another way to kind of take advantage of the self-mill archetype. There's a couple different ways, like I said, we can build this. With green, we get access to these. There was a Grixis version I saw that's playing Phoenix. We can go Esper to actually play like Lingering Souls, effects like that. So I want to try this as it is. I think I might, all things considered, over Foundry, because we're not taking too much effect of Foundry. I think Kieran might be a better card, all things considered. While you mill one less card, it gives you a whole bunch of more utility in terms of the actual effects. So I think we end up going with this in the long run, but I'm going to give it a shot and see how it plays out first. And we'll kind of take it to there. I got to Diamond already with Mono Green Stomp and Explore. So we're going to try it out, see how this plays out while we're on the rank floor. The best place to be is the rank floor, because you can try out whatever you want. Never feel bad about losing, because you can't go down. So as this game starts up, just a reminder for all my videos for the month of April, any money I make off YouTube, any revenue, so views, memberships, anything like that, ad revenue, every single penny I am donating to a Toronto-based food bank. So I will donate all the money. I'm hoping to do a couple hundred dollars. The goal is 500, so if you can, like this video, comment on it, subscribe to the channel, anything to help the algorithm kind of suggest it, but just watch the videos on the channel. It costs you nothing and it helps to go to the cause. Greatly appreciate it if you can. I'm trying to help out my local community. I help those who are hungry and maybe down on their luck a bit financially right now. This hand is a mulligan because we are short. So I think we put the Creeping Chill back. So I can go Foundry. So I can see what's going and discard. Then target opponent. And we are going to discard a Silver Smoke Ghoul. We will get rid of the Divine Purge. So we'll mill ourselves next turn. A little unfortunate just how like the hand kind of came to be. And just not hitting anything there also feels terrible. So we can do this at instant speed, so we'll wait till our opponent's turn. And then what we can do is I can... I'll do it now. So how it works is because I was already at the end step, I won't get that back to my following turn. So I think we're gonna do this again. And I think we're just gonna go after their hand. I think I keep Woe Strider. Just because it gives me a sac outlet. Nah, let's go for it. Like Satyr Wayfinder, Grisly Salvage would have been nice. We're missing a green land. Okay, so they're on the veto plan. I don't think I care about veto. We need to be mindful of this Wandering Emperor. They're on the Myrex, which is interesting. Probably put Vito back. So we should have done this on main phase 2, so just learning about our sequencing here. So they might do Wandering Emperor. So I'm expecting Wandering Emperor to get rid of Prized Amalgam here. I hope you're ready to... Interesting. So they go Haunted Dead. I am almost sad to see you go. So do that. We get Silversmote back. Not bad, not bad. So they need a sweeper here. But even with a sweeper, I get back. Okay, so Purge exiles these, which is a bit annoying. Remember your training. So I think we do need to take the Emperor off the battlefield. No creatures there. We were hoping for like Nacromeoba or something. I got another Stitcher. The Divine Purge is like really annoying because if it was just a normal sweeper, it would have been fine. Oh geez. Farewell. You know, all things considered, it wasn't like the worst. They usually only play one Farewell. So they got my Woe Strider. So I'm going to go Silversmote here because it could come back from the graveyard in the same way, but also I can sack it to draw two cards, so it just kind of keeps the fuel going. So Castle Ardenvale here seems a lot better just because they would have been able to block. Now they could have another Wandering Emperor, just Purge again hurts. So I can cycle this. I think we're just doing this, to be honest. Okay, double Nacromeoba. I'm going to hold this because I can cycle that. So we've seen now three Divine Purge and a Farewell. I'd have to assume that that would be it from them. So I can go silversmote. I can do this. If they have a counter, it feels kind of bad. So we'll do this for the turn. Kind of force them into the sweeper here. We are one mana short of doing both. Actually pretty impressive if we can pull this off, just given the amount of exile and just the tax being kind of an annoying. So we did that. We get to mill over here. We still have four Glimpse the Unthinkable. Jeez, we just can't hit. We know one of the Creeping Chills is in the yard. We have one Silver Smote. Just do the attack here. Do you have the veto? Alright, double Creeping Chill. Got him! Alrighty. So we will go from there. That was a good win. Farewell, we bet. We bet three Divine Purges. Our cards. We were casting five mana Stitcher Suppliers. Just going to town. Pretty resilient. Because they can't really pressure. Like, Castle Ardenvale would have been so much better for them. I really don't know why they're playing the Myrex. You still need 10 hits to kill them. Like, as opposed to the castle, which can also protect your creatures and fix your mana. Alrighty. Not as many folks in Diamond Historic yet. This hand looks sweet. Keep. Give a hello. Okay, no creatures, kinda sad. Oh my god. Okay, I gotta be somewhat cautious because they can also mill us. So I think the plan here is just discard and then get it back. I don't want to Glimpse the Unthinkable because 10 cards is a lot and we might not be able to kill them in time. Yeah, they're just cut downing that, it's fine. So we have one ghoul, one brutality in the yard. So I'm gonna use founding. Do we see Stitcher come out? So that's exile, which is a bit annoying. So we are gonna go like this. Yikes. Okay, they only hit one Creeping Chill, one Prized Amalgam. So I'm actually gonna do this. Oh no, no! I don't have the mana. Okay, we're gonna take a chance. I forgot to... I forgot to shock that in. We were supposed to do the collective. I have 19 cards in the yard. We're going to hope they don't have Tasha. Creeping Chill? They have Tasha, then I'm dead. It was risky. I shouldn't have done that. Okay, we hit Creeping Chill. So here, we're going to do both of these. Discard that. Why didn't that come off the Creeping Chill? They have Jace. How many Creeping Chills do I have left? Two. No! I have one line left. That's so annoying! Because Tasha's fine, like, we beat Jace, we just don't beat Tasha. Oh my god, that's so annoying. So annoying. Like, it didn't end up mattering. Okay, so Tasha beats us, but it's a little bit of a tricky one, because, like, how much do you mill? We gained 3 life, I don't understand why it didn't come back. Because you got to be mindful how much you self-mill. Like, they had the ritual there that did it. We are 2 points of damage short. They had us beat 2 ways. The hope was that one of our last 2 cards was just Creeping Chill, even hard cast it, we could have won. Yeah, sometimes they're just gonna get you. Got the nice water grave. I think I'm gonna do both. So it's Grease Fang. So they can set up a chariot, they have Vessel and Ascency. Nacromeoba. See if we can hit some more goodies in the yard. Oh no, all lands. It's pretty good because I can just discard then after. We did hit two boundaries, which is a little annoying. Okay, they did hit the Sky Sovereign. They can blow up a couple of my things if they do find Greasy Boy. Start with attacking. Try to find a land here. So can do this, get back. So they'll get the boat. So I should set a stop after second main. They should, I'm guessing, target prized amalgam here. Get that back, get the 3 power, and it's exactly 9 damage, and the opponent's dead. So they were actually safe if they just took out something else there. Like, it was face-up information. Alrighty, 2-1. Very, very close one against Mill. If they had Grease Fang, or if they had Parhelion, it's obviously a lot better, but... I don't think Woe Strider's necessarily right then. It's been a bit slow. We want, I think, maybe recursive. One sec. I don't love the Woe Strider. 3 mana is a lot, and we're seeing it. We're just dumping our hand. So let's get rid of Woe Strider. What about Eben? No. Mill. We can go with like Secret Keeper. I want recurring mill. There was the escape card. Sweet Oblivion. Target player mills 4 cards and then for 4 mana. Let's try that one out. Jace is going to be a little tough to actually pull off, I think. Plus, we have no way of bringing it back. The Satyr Wayfinder is nice. We could go Vessel of Nascency as well, similar to like the Greasefang plan, where you're just trying to mill in that regard. Two and one, not bad. Hand would have been great if we had a blue source. So the problem with this hand is a lot of your payoffs. Are kind of here already. Maybe we try this still. Put like a nacromeoba back, just have this as an in-hand lightning helix. I do think current over the foundry is probably where we want to be. Would elect a grisly salvage. So I didn't set up for the grisly salvage turn because I don't have this land out, so I think we just put some pressure on for this turn. Okay. They're using removal there, it's fine. Try to hit something. At least hit a creeping chill. But we're hoping for a little bit more gas. Like a collective brutality doesn't really do much. I think we're just gonna grisly salvage here. We're gonna get this, because we'll get the ghoul back. They're on like Phyrexian Arena, so it's probably like mono black devotion. And the nice thing is sequencing, even if they have a sweeper here, I get this back the following turn. And then I have 3 damage plus the creeping chill damage. So we get them that way there. Plus we get nacromeoba. It's lightning helix! This deck's sick. I think we try the Karen. I want to see how that one goes. So the upside is the binding does let us recast stuff. I think we just keep going with this. Because like that game, if we had teachings and we don't get the flashback grisly salvage, which just doesn't get the ball rolling. Vessel and Nascency might be what we want though instead of the escape card. The bonus of the escape card is when we kind of mill it over, we do have the ability to just cast it. There's a lot of like little nuance with this where we're just trying to figure out what works. This hand looks good. So I can go one Stitcher. Okay, Angels might be tough. Oh, this one's gonna be good. Okay, so do this. Do this. So I want to try to find a collected company. The target opponent, kill this. Get rid of you. Okay, I did take him off a land, which is nice. Um, No attacks. We're still in a bit of trouble just because they can gain like a whole bunch of life. The no answer line's a little rough. We also take quite a bit. But we mill. Could collective brutality again. Okay, so salvage is nice. We'll do that. I'm going to do this main phase in case we hit an untapped land. So here I could Takanuma and then have that as a cycle effect. But I think we just Blooming Marsh here because I have Sweet Oblivion. Thank you. Try to get as much gas as possible for this flip. How many copies in my yard? Two prized amalgams. Ah, shit. Okay, so now they're on. So we can't actually win. See what we do here. The problem is they gain 7 life and then a bunch of extra life. The Angels matchup seems awful. Did hit another nacromeoba. We did hit silversmote. Maybe? Because I have creeping chill in hand. And they went Giada there. Giada gains him 6 life. Problem is they gain so much life. Like, we did so much damage this game, but... Ooh, maybe I get them with the creeping chill line. Where they do blocks to keep themselves over 27. And then I can get something to die, maybe? You don't see too much angels in Historic anymore, but our deck's just not equipped to beat that. Like, they had a nice draw. If they didn't draw the Righteous, they're just gaining 4 a turn, it's fine, because they're not able to trigger the Resplendent. But once they have Bishop and that, like, 4 life a turn is fine. We can outpace that. We saw how wide of a board we were able to generate. It's just... 9 life and the anthem effect and just all the blockers. Trying to get them like on an awkward block, but there wasn't really much we could do there. Like, you could... There's not really... Like, I can't beat that matchup. That's just one you chalk up to. They're going to have your number and they're going to beat you that way. So we have one Creeping Chill in hand, which kind of sucks, but otherwise the hand looks good. Probably should have shocked in. Okay, so we can... don't necessarily want to exile that. Ah. We needed that foundry. I mean, if this is Rakdos mid, they're gonna kill a lot of my stuff. Just fine. I'm gonna hold on to the Paseju because it can let me blow up a creature land. Or Hive of the Eye Tyrant, ideally. Mana. This is always going to be in the graveyard. Bring an opponent for three there. So I could hold up Paseju, but I think we're just going to be mindful of our life total, respect it there. It's a good sign. That means they don't really have an answer. Our things are all kind of crappy creatures, so anything they kill doesn't have a huge amount of value. Probably fine as a double block. Would have loved the foundry. I'm gonna do this. So get rid of glimpses are good. Creeping chills are good. Nothing of use? Kidding me? Gone through like... we're hitting like all the wrong half of our deck. Very frustrating. Oh, come on! Who the hell mains go blank in best of one? That out. We can block something. What do we got left in our deck? Got two Creeping Chills, four Silversmotes. Okay. Actually decent. Shieldred's annoying because now I can't even race. Jeez. Just this one's getting to me because it's like, okay, so you have Go Blank, which is a card that these Rakdos lists pretty much never actually play. Now it's gonna be Molten Impact and like Thoughtseize. Or just perfect. Yeah, I just that one's frustrating. Just not hitting what you need. Like, the Oblivion's fine, I think. We just didn't get any of our... If we get the Foundry down, we're good. If we can get, like, any of the draw 10s, it's the fact that everything we milled over, no creatures. Bottom third of the deck, we had four Silversmote. So couldn't even cheat those into play. I'm really salty about Go Blank. None of the Rakdos mid-range lists that I see for best of one play. That hand's not gonna do. This hand's good. We can glimpse ourselves for 10. Not bad, not bad. So we'll mill ourselves. I can use Grisly Salvage. Yeah, that's actually scary. Okay, we got nacromeoba. So we can do another glimpse here. Could have the lifelink. You don't see Borosaurus too often. I have three creeping chills left. Could be like Sticky Fingers or Hammer Hand, so that can't block. They have a lifelink. They do. I'm probably dead. Drawing the creeping chills a bit awkward. Needed him not to have it. Hopefully no trample. It's a good start at least, but they get Audacity. It's pretty big game. Yeah, that'll get him Audacity. Oh, and this thing's got Vigilance. It's all these life gain decks. It's a bit tricky. Like, we're trying to jank. We can have very explosive games, but once an opponent just sticks like a lifelinker in, we have like a set amount of damage. We're like a 20 to 25. There's decks that you can obviously push through much more damage, but this is not one of them. So this is likely Wizards. Let's try. So I can Foundry, Grisly, Salvage. It just, I could still be Wizards. We'll do this. We set ourselves up pretty nice. This could just be burn. No, Wizards. Okay, they're gonna hit me hard. Okay, Creeping Chill's great because it gets me back a bunch of stuff. And those come back on my opponent's end step. I can flashback something from my graveyard, which will be the Collective Brutality or the Salvage. Actually, I can mill 10. We'll see what they do here, how much damage they put out. The Truths is interesting. It's 8-11. Okay, so I could Collective Brutality, discard, discard. Or I can Grisly Salvage, or I could just Creeping Chill. I think I do this. And I'm gonna use all modes. Okay, so target opponent reveals. Gonna kill you. You're gonna lose life. Discard. Discard. Get rid of the Wizard's Lightning. It's the most efficient thing. So we do this. They kill something, they Reckless Rage. They can also just go face. Mentor's Guidance is good. Get some two draws, two triggers. Could find them potentially a land and something else. I have another Silversmote in the yard. So I just need to survive, and then they're dead. Very aggressive line. They're dead on board. They could have held back, but I guess they don't get much value there. Alright, I'm gonna wrap this one up. Let me know what you think in the comments. Kind of a cool strategy, something you don't see that often, but we're pretty much like a 50% deck. So whoever was running it ran really hot, all things considered. In any case, thanks for watching. Hope you have a great one, and see you next time.